NZ First will take 4 seats out of 20 around the cabinet table in the coalition deal with Labour, announced on Thursday. The agreement is supported by the Greens outside cabinet. But how does it compare to previous coalitions in New Zealand under MMP? It is the first time in 9 years the decision-making body at the heart of New Zealand government will feature more than one party. In the previous 3 governments, the National Party held all 20 cabinet posts. Before then, in 2005 and in 2002, Labour had 19 out of 20 cabinet posts. The remaining one was held by Jim Anderton, who was at that time representing Jim Anderton's Progressive Coalition. The last time the biggest party had to make any meaningful concessions of cabinet posts was in 1999. When Labour agreed to give 4 posts to the Alliance Party, then led by Anderton. After the first election under mixed member proportional representation in 1996, NZ First threw its support behind National and received 5 cabinet posts in return. So has NZ First won a disproportionate number of cabinet posts, relative to its level of support or in comparison to previous coalition deals? Cabinet posts are never likely to reflect a proportionate share of the vote, and nor should they be. The party or parties that manage to scrape past 50% of the votes can divide up 100% of the cabinet seats. Nonetheless, here are the numbers: NZ First has 20% of the cabinet, with 7.2% of the votes. In 1996, the party led by Winston Peters made up 25% of the cabinet after winning 13.35% of the total votes. Then in 1999, Alliance made up 20% of cabinet after winning 7.74% of the votes. Ministers outside cabinet. A second sweetener in coalition deals is ministerial posts outside of cabinet. National offered plenty of these to its support partners over the past 9 years. In the current deal, NZ First will get 1 of these and the Greens 3. What's the big deal with cabinet? A seat at the cabinet table is a seat at the heart of government. Cabinet ministers get to have a say on big decisions and are across all areas of the government's agenda. Ministers outside cabinet only have influence over their portfolio area.